Howdy guys, I'm back with more Path of Exile, The Fall of Oriath. I just entered the Grand Promenade here. Last time I spent a lot of time exploring the eastern half of the map, and for no real reason at all, I decided I wanted to explore the western half today. So I went through the toxic conduits and thought I would take a look around here and see where the heck I end up. Off camera, I did finally find a way out of the situation I was stuck in, and I found a waypoint at the Solaris Concourse, but I didn't finish going through the area because it looks like there's another area that leads out or something. I don't really know. This act seems to be a bit of a mess as far as the areas go. I know I was kind of griping about the size, but now that I've kind of been playing a little bit, it seems like there's like a lot of areas where maybe I'm wrong, but they don't really seem to serve much of a purpose. They're just there to walk through. I don't know if I'm being fair in saying that, but that's just kind of how it seems to me, that a lot of these places are just here to run through. There's no quests or rhyme or reason to any of this, which, you know, it's not a huge deal. I mean, pre-Oriath, there's plenty of areas that had you had no reason to go to. In fact, there was like one place in Act 2 I don't think you ever went to for any reason, was there? I don't really remember, but I know there's a few areas that there's just not really a whole lot going on there. And, well, I feel like the biggest crime of Oriath is not only are these areas, do they not serve really any purpose? There's no quests or anything in here to do, or anything to do. But the fact is that they're kind of recycled areas, I think, makes it even worse. So it's like, oh my gosh, why am I here? What do I have to do, you know? But I'm just making it through, so this is the Grand Promenade. It's looks like it's probably a little dark out or something, kind of dim, but nothing really to write home about. It's not the most exciting area. You got a lot of the same, kind of just same old stuff. You know, you got fancy fountains, you got specters, you've got all sorts of stuff. You know, nothing is really jumping out at me here in the Grand Promenade. Really curious to see how this map is going to fill out. It looks like everything has gone in a complete circle, so I don't know. I guess this is, you can kind of pick a direction and go, and you'll eventually find where you need to be. And of course, I started out on the eastern part, and like I said, that's why I decided I just felt like checking out the western half of the map, because I haven't been over here yet. And gotta say, I'm feeling a little disappointed, you know, compared to how cool Act 5 was, even Act 6. Man, especially Act 5. Act 5 was really awesome, and starting to see why people are kind of feeling a bit disappointed with, I mean, not to say that Oriath has been a disappointment. It's been great. I'm still really enjoying it. Don't misunderstand me. All the great stuff that's happening, and Oriath is great. Please don't misunderstand me. I love Oriath, but I'm kind of starting to see some of the, I guess, negative parts of it, because you know that you've always got your the people that are going to find the, I want to call them naysayers, but that doesn't really seem like the right term. I guess people that are a bit more skeptical. You know, I was singing praises about Oriath in Act 5, and as I'm going through it, you know, the cracks are starting to show and becoming more and more apparent. I've already complained about the dialogue at length, and now I'm kind of feeling like, okay, yeah, these maps feel a little bit on the lazy side. They're really, really big. All right, GGG, I get it. You can make really, really big maps with not a whole lot going on. Okay. I mean, I know I'm seriously complaining about actually having to play the game. I know I'm so ridiculous, but I don't know. I think for like the leveling stuff, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong in saying this, but I feel like the leveling stuff shouldn't be like these big giant areas. It should kind of, you know, corral you from one story point to the next, because there's a lot of people that just want to get through the story too, right? So I can't imagine going through these big areas is a lot of fun for people that just want to get through the game so they can do the end game stuff. And for people like me that even, you know, kind of enjoy the story, this really isn't good either. I know a lot of it's me and my own speed, but come on, these maps are enormous. I mean, okay, here, I'm gonna stop, and here's the door out. Alright, so I had no quests here, nothing to talk to, no and things to interact with, and I didn't go down every single nook and cranny, but look, this place is just long. For the sake of being long. It's not even a big area, it's just long. So, you guys just watched me go through all that. Now, I'm not going to mouse back over because that's ridiculous, but these areas are enormous, and not a lot going on for how enormous they are. Like, I don't know if there's a... I don't know. I mean, like, it's strange because I like the end game maps. I don't mind big maps when... I guess it's the lack of treasure. You're not getting any treasure, so it doesn't feel as exciting to go through all of these little... Yeah, see, there is nothing there, not even a waypoint. The Grand Promenade, like more like the Grand Boar. All right, so I'm here in the bathhouse, Hidden Sin, where revelry thrives. And looks like everything connects, so this whole... act goes in a circle, except for here. Looks like there's a little side area or something. Alright, so I have my passive skill point, and I can finally put it in this Born to Fight, which is really nice. Gives me a lot of melee physical damage. Now, I do think I really should go down here and grab the maximum life stuff and probably grab, I don't know about the warrior's blood, life regen, I don't know about that. That might be worth getting, but, you know, after that, I'm not really sure what I should do next. You know, I've really got to start thinking about my endgame build because I'm level 64 now, so realistically, I'm probably only going to have about 20-ish or so points to play with. So, you know, I can route this way and grab the life, but I've got so much stuff over here I need to grab. I don't know if I ever want to mess around with, like, the bleeding stuff. Where'd it go? Like, this stuff, Red Storm and Crimson Dance. I guess maybe at some point. And I know this build uses blood magic, so I'm probably going to... I think when I'm ready to get this, I'm probably going to have to save up 4 points and get, like, this whole node all at the same time, because I'm really nervous about getting blood magic. I'm very scared. And then I also have to consider I'm probably going to want to get one of these nodes, depending on what weapon I end up with. I've had axes for a really, really long time, but, you know, I might end up with a really cool mace or a really cool sword. You know, I'm kind of feeling it might be time to just, you know, go ahead and go with the axes, but I just don't really know what I should do at this point. You know, and like I said, I can always get more life. I feel like my life is, I'm kind of getting to an okay point with it right now, so not really too terribly sure what exactly I want to do with my build from this point. I'm not really sure what I need. I'm still not really dying a whole lot. So, gargoyles. So, I'm not really worried so much about dying anymore like I once was, but I feel like my damage might be a bit on the low side. At the same time, I think my damage will probably really be helped when I finish up the Merciless Lab and I can get my next ascendancy points. So I'm not really sure where I should go, though. Probably that, but I'll worry about my Merciless Lab when I get to the Merciless Lab. It says that there's a trial of ascendancy in this area, so I can actually start working toward the trials for the Merciless Labyrinth. And given how few I've seen in Act 8, I'm going to go ahead and assume that the other Merciless trials are in Act 9. And gosh, I guess I'm getting toward the end here. If Act 8 is like this, I know maybe I'm just, I don't know if I'm feeling just extra negative today or what, but I've kind of feel like I'm gonna be a little disappointed in Act 9 and 10. I'm not gonna lie, Act 8's been, well, I mean, all of the acts after 5, they've had their moments that were like, oh my gosh, this is great. And then some of them are like, that's it, really? That's all we're going to talk about? Like, all the Groost and Silk stuff, no one has seemed sufficiently upset about any of that. And that bugged me. Okay, so we've got like some dead plants and trees here in this bathhouse. The Lunaris Concourse. Okay. So that's gonna spit us out over there. I'm just gonna peek my head in real quick just to be sure I'm right. I'm pretty sure I'm right. I don't really plan on going through the Lunaris Concourse right now. I just wanted to pop my head in here and see if maybe a waypoint is super close by if I could ever be so lucky. And I don't think I'm a lucky ducky today with a easy to find right at the front waypoint. So I'm gonna go ahead and just pop right back into where I was because I'm not quite finished in the bathhouse. I have quite a few things to do. I have to find some Wings of Vestiri, and I have a trial, and there's a side area in here too, so not quite ready to go to the Lunaris Concourse just yet. But yeah, no one seemed sufficiently upset about Groost or Silk back in the last act, where, everyone seemed sufficiently upset about, like, Nessa back in Act 6, and Act 5 was great. You can definitely tell there was a lot of time spent on making Act 5 cool, but the quality of, like, each subsequent act has pretty noticeably gone down in a lot of different ways. The characters don't seem to care much about each other, and the dialogue is screwed up, and the maps are just big for the sake of being big, not really a lot going on. Starting to kind of, I don't know, I mean, like, I hate to be so negative, I really do. I'm just, not pulling the punches, it's just how I feel right now. I know that, I almost feel like anything past Act 6 just feels almost kind of like a beta to me, to be honest. Like, it feels just not quite complete. All right, Tomb of Hector Titusius and the Wings of Vestiri, and mounting her mighty rock, Garrukan, Holy Queen of the Sky, descended upon her enemies and their armies of darkness. Awesome. All right, so I do have a trial in here as well, so I do need to keep looking around until I find that trial, which maybe is down here, I don't know. Of course, I do, like I said, I do realize that a lot of my problems with my speed and getting through the areas are my own. So, I do choose to sit here and cut through everything. So, the only reason a lot of these areas are slow is because I'm choosing to be slow. So, I do understand that, some of these problems are my own doing, but, not
Over
every.
here,
Oh,
Exile.
hi, Tora. All right, Tora. If I'll do your mission if it happens to be on the way, and only if it happens to be on the way, because your stuff kind of tends to be a pain in the butt and out of the way. All right, so it looks like my trial is over here. So let's see. I'm curious to see. Since the bath area or this bathhouse is a completely new area, I'm expecting a new trial,
On the
but.
night of a thousand ribbons, our finest city burned. It burned with fires lit by cruelty and neglect. It burned with shame for giving the title of emperor to a man who did not deserve it.
Okay, so we've got a standard flaming puzzle trial here, which these annoy me because I hate waiting, which, I mean, it's not terribly hard, it's just a matter of waiting, thank goodness, right? But man, ARPGs really... Oh, I didn't mean to click on the locked door. I just meant to come over here to take refuge. ARPGs really aren't, like, the best designed games for, like, puzzles and stuff like that. I mean, you know, this, like, isometric view or whatever the heck you call it. And then just the nature of the game. It's like, really, we're doing...
I believe in traveling light.
Oh, we're doing puzzles in an ARPG? Like, I know, I'm so negative today. I really think I'm just being super negative. I think it's just me having a bad day or something. I'm just complaining. I guess I woke up on the wrong side of the bed this morning or something. I don't know, it's weird. I don't feel like I'm annoyed or anything. I don't feel particularly irritable. I don't know, I feel like complaining about my favorite game today for some reason. As if I could do any better, right? Alright, so speaking of puzzle sucking and ARPGs, alright, there we go.
Allow your wisdom to be tempered by the flames of the past.
Alright, so that was the first Merciless trial. So I've got two more to go, and I know I haven't been to every area in Act 8 yet, but I kind of feel like that I'm not really going to see any more trials. I feel like the other trials are probably going to be in Act 9, but I have been wrong before, so whatever. Alright, so this goes to the High Gardens. Alright, I'm just gonna poke my head in here really fast. I feel like we talked about this area with an NPC or something before. I don't seem to have any quests out here. Creeping Dread chokes life from this thriving terrace, so I'm not seeing any waypoints right off the bat here, so I'm gonna go. Oh, I wanna kill this, but I am gonna go ahead and just pop back out. See, I'm just running around all over the place in this act because it's not that I don't know where to go, it's just everything just kind of feels a little bit like a mess to me. Okay, well, here's Taurus stuff. I guess I do get to take care of that super duper fast. Hopefully that, well, nope. Oh gosh, she wants me to hunt down 46 beasts. To be honest, I really didn't plan on being here that much longer. I got my wings. I was actually going to bounce out. Oh, well, good thing I didn't, I guess. That's pretty nice to get. Yeah, I just wanted to take a quick look around here real quick. Yeah, I don't really know if I feel like doing Tora's thing, to be perfectly honest. I know I need the reputation, but I really think I just need to get to the Lunaris Concourse where I was. It's kind of why I'm walking in this direction. And then I'm probably going to need to bounce back real quick and clean out my inventory. I mean, if Tora's stuff is on the way, I've got half of Tora's things. I really just don't want to have to run all over the place out of my way. I know I'm complaining about having to play the game. It's just that I've already cleared this area. I'd just be walking around a graveyard. I'm not doing it. Sorry. Okay. If it was if I had found her, or if it was a map or something, you know, I would do it. But I'm over level. I'm 64 in a level 58 area. Like, I just kind of want to get out of here now. Okie dokie, I was hoping for an upgrade there. No, I didn't think so, no. Alright, I'm gonna run back to town real quick and give, I need to give Hargan this, these wings here, because this has taken up a lot of inventory space. I have a lot of stuff taking up inventory space right now. Gonna go ahead and just throw this stuff in here, and my gem there, and my card there. Alright, Hargan, I have what you need.
You found them! No easy feat, I bet. How's old Hector these days? Not so good after you crossed paths with them, am I right? I'll polish these wings up and get them back to their owners, just as soon as my Mariketh friend can get her folks to pay the ransom. Price, I mean. In the meantime, take a little something from my stock as payment.
You are a shady, shady dude. Oh, nice. 4% 4% increased effect of your curses. That's kind of cool. Mana. Actually, none of these seem. These all seem like really low amounts. 3% reduced mana cost of skills. 2% reduced mana reserve. 4% increased skill effect duration. 3% chance to avoid elemental ailments. 8% life recovery from flesh. 2% chance to dodge attacks. Truth be told, I really don't see myself using any of these, so I'm just gonna grab one of them and just throw it in the bank. I mean, not that I have anything particularly. Well, you know, actually, that's not true. I've actually got some pretty amazing jewels. That's an old one right there, but here's this one too. That one's pretty nifty, I guess, if you just need raw stats, but this would be cool too if I had the right abilities. See, I've got quite a few. Decent. Yeah, like here's the most valuable thing I've gotten so far out of solo self-found intuitive leap, which, you know, I feel like that's something I'm gonna have to plan around if I'm going to use it, which I don't know if I should or not. Maybe, I don't know. I'm not good at figuring this stuff out, right? Alright, that's no good, and that's okay, but not without movement speed, not for me. Alright, through the Lunaris Concourse, then, I guess. You know, like I said, I didn't even finish going through the Solaris Concourse, which is on the other side over here. I only went through about half of it, enough to find the waypoint. So I'm guessing the Solaris Temple is there, and the Lunaris Temple is probably there. So, I don't know. I guess. Well, because I went through. No, the Solaris Temple was there. I've already been there. I'm derping. All right, so I have no idea what that little place there is. I guess no. I'm wrong. I bet that's the Lunaris Temple, and that's mystery place because this is going off into the garden or something. That, you know what? I'll find out when I get there instead of speculating because I'm just making an ass out of myself now. How embarrassing. Alright, so moseying along, still in, plus this is like, this concourse is like what, I can't remember what the area was called from, Act 3, and I don't want to look at it right now. Let's see, this area is like the barracks, right, I guess is what this is supposed to be like. So, I mean, they are the same areas, they're with higher level mobs, and they're set out up a little bit differently, but these are, for the most part, kind of the same area. See, here's all the grass and gardening, like, you know, this was the way toward the hedge maze and all of that back in Act 3, right? Like, in fact, I think I should jump down here and see what's up against this wall, if anything. Doesn't seem to. Oh, hey, look, guys. Look at that. My very first map for this character. A crystal ore map. That is my very first. Yep, see, look, I even got a new help page. I know, I keep saying I'm going to look at these and then I never do. Although the main storyline ends at Act 10, hundreds, if not thousands, of hours of fun still lay ahead by way of a special kind of item called maps. Oh my, this help page is really, really actually quite cute. I know I've said that before and I keep saying I should probably actually look at that and then I never do. As soon as I turn my recording off, I forget about that again until I start recording again and something else pops up. I seriously just keep forgetting about it. And you know, the thing is, there's so much, this game is so complicated that, you know, I'm not trying to say I know what I'm doing, because I don't, but, you know, people that are veterans still might find something pretty interesting in there. I mean, you know, there's so many, like, vendor recipes and all sorts of good things. Like, the recipes are really, really cool. I really like the whole vendor recipe thing, but my gosh, if it's so hard to, I guess it's just one of those things that the more you play, it becomes, like, second nature, because I sure as heck don't have any of them memorized other than, like, the super obvious ones, like the one for the chromatic orb with the, you know, one of each color being linked, or the six stuff with six slots. I mean, the obvious stuff, right? But with, as far as like trading in, what is it, like an iron ring and a skill gem or whatever, and then the rustic sash with a weapon and a blacksmith stone or what? I think that's it. I'd have to double check, but there's, and that's only a few of them. Then you've got, you know, your stuff for your alchemy orbs, stuff for boots, stuff for orbs of chance. I mean, there's recipes for so much different stuff, right? And I guess if I'm going to be playing SSF, it's really in my best interest to, oh, Nightbringer Lucius. It's really, isn't this where, like, Gravicius or whatever his name was? Isn't that kind of where he used to be? But yeah, I guess if I'm going to be playing SSF, I should really know those recipes quite a lot better. But, you know, I can always bring it up on my second monitor or whatever if I need to. But, just kind of hard to refer to it when I'm recording, right? Ooh, I like this stairwell. This looks kind of cool. Alright, let me get this guy. Nice, nice. Is that... Oh, I thought it was a 5-link. It's just 5 slots. What a bummer. Alright, so this is one of this area's exits, and there are 2. This is the Lunaris Temple, so let's see what side this puts us on of the map. Oi, Act 8, you are a mess. Alright, so this is the Lunaris Temple, which means I have no clue what that is there in the middle. Ooh, it's really blue and pretty in here. This is not the Lunaris Temple that I remember. It's in a lot better shape than I remember it, and... Well, I guess I'm about to put a lot more bodies in it, though, aren't I? Aren't I? What is with this guy? Come here, dude. Jeez, wasn't even worth chasing after. Yeah, I definitely like all of the blue and stuff. This is a pretty... And even the ribbons are blue. I know, it's like... It's cool, but it's also like... So, it's also pretty lazy because it's like all they did was take the Solaris Temple and make everything that was red and make it blue. Like, I'm not even trying to rag on it or anything. That's what it is. Like, tell me that this stuff all isn't red in the Solaris Temple. I don't know. I think the banners there might be a little different or something. I think the symbols might be different. That's about it. But... This is through and through a blue Solaris temple. Well, there's also a lot of... there's like these flower petals. I don't know what these little blue blobs on the ground are. In my mind, they're flower petals, okay? I mean, for all I know, they're probably drops of blue blood or something. But in my mind, they're flower petals. Those right there, like these things. Let me stop killing stuff, but yeah, see these little blue blobby things? Those are going to be flower petals, because I have no clue what they are, so in my mind, they're flower petals. Oh boy, alright, this is kind of a cool area, though. I mean, even though it's just rehashed temple, it's still a cool area. I still like it. I mean, I guess it's amazing what a different hue will do for an area. Like, I've mentioned this before, but like Calm's Dream, I just really don't like areas with a bunch of red. I think I'm just weird, but it just, I don't know, makes me uncomfortable. Like, I like the blueness. It's nice. It's blue's a nice calming color. It's easy on the eyes. I don't know. I'm just goofy, I guess. Alright, so what did I miss over here? Am I crazy or is this just not a big area? I am supposed to be looking
over
for...
Over here, Exile.
What the heck? Did Tor just appear here? Alright, sure, I guess I'll do that real quick. I am supposed to be looking for a moon orb, and I'm pretty sure I'm in the right place for it, so there's got to be a little... teeny tiny little bridge or something I'm missing, huh? Alright, let's finish getting these guys. See, I don't mind doing Tora's missions when they're like this. I just hate the ones where you've got to track down 3,000 different monsters, right? Okay, is there any chance that I'm drunk right now? Because I'm not seeing where to go in here. If there's a second level, like, am I supposed to... not be in here? Am I crazy? Find the moon orb, a Lunaris temple. Okay, so I have to be in the right spot. There's probably some tiny little nook that I didn't go down. It was probably in here. I was too busy taking in the sights, right? Is that what happened? Was I... Nope, I've been up here. Nothing I can jump... Oh, derp, it's over here off to the... Oh, I didn't see this door. I'm so stupid. Me playing video games. Well, I'm excited that I got my first map, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to do, like, I guess I can do mapping now because I have a map device in my hideout, don't I? So I guess nothing's actually stopping me from doing a map right now if I wanted to. Of course, I don't really know exactly if that's a great idea or not, but I think that I should be able to do it because the map, the tier 1 maps are like the high 50s and I'm like 60 something. So I think I can do it, right? If I just go back to my hideout and use my little map device I've got laying around there now. I'm guessing when you go up one of these temples here, I don't know if the map, one of the map devices is going to be there to use, or if you, I'm not really sure how maps exactly are going to get introduced. Okay, you know what, since I've got the waypoint here, just for science, alright, I'm going to go back to my hideout here, and don't mind my statues. It's last time I showed you guys it was a work in progress. It's still a work in progress. I'm waiting to get one of my masters to level 7 to get it all decked out, so still a work in progress. Alright, so I have a map device here, so will I be able to use this? Oh, you know what? I should upgrade it, right? There we go. Alright, inhabited by ghosts. Let's go with that then. Activate. Oh, you cannot access endgame content until you have completed Act 10. Alright, well, science for science, guys. You're welcome. I'm joking. But, okay, well, I'm gonna have to, this is usually my map tab, so I'm gonna have to do, like, look at, I need some more tabs. Like, I know I have one that's completely empty. I just throw stuff everywhere. I swear I don't live my real my real life is not as messy as my POE life, I promise. I'm a lot more tidy IRL. I don't really know why I'm deciding to be so messy with my tabs. There's some organization there, a little bit. There is some rhyme and reason to it. Oh, okay, so looks like they cleaned out the bodies and the blood out of here. Now you've got all these... Look at these elegant statues! I want some of these. Where do I get the silver statues? I want... I'm serious. I want the silver statues for my hideout. All I've got are gold statues. I want silver ones. Those are pretty. I know this is going to sound weird and a little not related to the game, but I actually am more fond of silver as far as a metal to wear than I am of gold. I don't know, gold doesn't suit me. It's just a personal preference. I don't care for gold. I think I like silver a lot more. I've worn silver my whole life. It's my favorite. I much prefer that, which is also good because I believe silver's quite a bit cheaper than gold, too. I'm such an easy lady to please. While we're on the topic, I don't even like diamonds. Really, I don't. Don't care for them. They're overpriced rocks. I mean, they're the only thing valuable about a diamond is how hard it is. It's good for, like, drill bits and stuff, right? Why people spend thousands on them to wear around their finger, I'd swear I'd never know. I'd rather have a bathtub filled with tiramisu or something. What a fat thing to say, but you guys know what I mean. Like, I don't know, don't care for the fancy rocks or the metals. Not for me. So anyway, I'm really liking what they've done with the Lunaris Temple. This is pretty cool down here. It's kind of spooky, but, you know, it's just really dark. And what are these, just pikes coming out of the ground? Okay, I guess they're just pikes. Definitely better than... Oh, well, here's the bodies. Never mind. I was going to say, things are definitely better, but, you know, we've got some of the same monster types here. You've got those ladies that like to projectile shoot at you. We've got some of the specters or whatever. And, yeah, see? Well, okay. One thing I gotta give it to him now in the Lunaris Temple is at least everyone's a mummy. You know, I mean, have you guys read what it takes to mummify someone? It's quite a process, right? So the fact that they mummified everyone here means that they at least spent the time to treat the bodies, you know, pull out the organs, use whatever, like, herbs or whatever salves they treat the bodies with, then wrap them up, and they're all on a bed with candles by them, or, you know, being loaded off carts, and there's candles everywhere. It's like the bodies were definitely treated better than before. Alright, never mind. Apparently I'm just full of it. It's like, Rurumiki, look a bit more to the left, where you will see tons and tons of bodies piled up in wagons. And it's like, oh, okay, guys, got it. Never mind, the bodies aren't treated much. Well, some of them are. Some are mummified. Some are on carts. Maybe they're being waited to be... Maybe they're... on the waiting list to be treated. Maybe the person that does the mummifications is off today. I don't know. Some of these bodies, it's weird. Like, there were some... Okay, so you still have these ladies here. In fact, I'm pretty sure they put more pixels in these. I don't remember their booties being such high definition over here. But, you go inside here and it's like, look, I'd say this body was treated really well. Look, he's even got, like, tea or something there. I don't really know what's going on here. You know, never mind everything I've said about this place. I was talking about how I love what they've done with the place and everything's nowhere near as creepy. Nope, this is just the same old stupid Lunaris Temple. Of course, you gotta admit, I left the Lunaris Temple in a pretty sad state. Maybe it takes a while to fix these things. I don't know. I mean, I figure if I have to clean out some place filled with bodies and the water is blood, I figure it's gonna take me quite a few months to get that tidied up. Of course, I'm a slow worker, so... Alright, killing naked ladies, running around, killing some ribbons. Back to more really big maps. Looks like the end is in sight, and there's a portal there. And I even got a... Oh, whoops, I'm trying to chop myself up. I got the Lunaris Priestess card. Cool. Once again, these statues. Where do I get a silver statue? I want one. I want one bad. Alright. Dusk, the Harbinger of Lunaris. Wow, this is cool looking. I actually think this is really neat looking. This whole, like... And it makes sense that the moon guy is wearing or using a bow or whatever. Isn't that the Roman goddess? Isn't the Roman goddess of moon use a bow or something too? I think so. Alright, and the moon orb. Moonlight is a wise mother. The moon which bathes us in soft cooling light does so with the intent of illuminating our paths. Moonlight is wisdom. Moonlight is life. I don't know, I think if I was going to be one, I'd be more of a sun worshipper. Ah, okay, so I'm going to bring these orbs here to the harbor bridge. Alright, well, I am going to pop back to town. Oops, that's not a portal scroll, that's a wisdom scroll. What are you doing here? Alright, so let's see if... Not quite. Like, that would have been not... This axe would have been good if it didn't have so much elemental damage on it. I'm using this brutality thing. Maybe I need to... take that off? I don't really know. I mean, yeah, I really don't know. I mean, I really don't want to go, I don't really want to go messing with my weapon until I really want something 5-linked, to be perfectly honest. I mean, don't we all, right? So, I'm not really sure if upgrading is, like, because, yeah, it is better than what I have, if you factor in the elemental damage, which I'm trying to get away from because of this brutality support. So I'm just going to set this aside here because I'm not really sure about it yet. And I know I'm going to, you know, start running into more upgrades and stuff. And I still do have, like, I've got some gray weapons. I can probably just honestly toss these at this point. I don't think these are going to ever be worth using an essence on at this point. But I still do have a pretty okay essence. It's level 45 now, so I didn't realize that I've actually out-leveled that essence pretty hard. Never mind on that one. Gosh, when did I get all grown up? Alright, I'm going to check if anyone's got any dialogue. Looks like he does. He had something about the wings that I just got for him, so I'm going to pick up this one first.
Well, they're forged from solid gold. I can tell you that much. But I suppose that's not really what you're asking about. The wings are a treasured piece of the Merikith heritage. Back when the tribes quit their squabbling and joined hands to battle the Eternal Empire, the wings were seen as a symbol of their unity. The Golden Sakima wore them as she led the whole bloody Merikith Horde against San. She was a single greatest hope for the Merikith, was that Asenath. Hector Tatusius crushed both their hopes and their precious Sakima.
There's like an odd question mark there, but it wasn't really a question. She wore them again, you know, that was kind of interesting. I don't know if anyone else noticed that little errant question. I don't know, it didn't seem like it fit there, but maybe I'm focusing too much on silly things. Alright, so I've got the orbs of sun and moon.
Powerful baubles, them orbs are. As old as Asmerians themselves, maybe even older. I've read all there is on them little beauties. The sun orb's said to contain all that has been, while its sister, the moon orb, holds all that will be, past and future, packed up neat behind glass and thaumaturgy. Shudder to think what might happen if all that got out one day.
What? And I'm just carrying that kind of power around in my bags.
Good
here, right
you.
Up underneath my orb of transmutations. Gosh, that feels a little strange, doesn't it? All right, how about you? Alright, what do you think of these orbs I'm lugging around?
By the earth and sky, the power of the goddesses lies in your hands. Take these seeds and plant them in the fertile stone at their feet. From what I have learned, it is my hope that the orbs will force Solaris and Lunaris to grow limbs and flesh, to engage you in mortal battle.
Oh, great.
May this come to pass. And may you cut down these goddesses as a forester might fell a pair of stubborn old trees.
Okay, so sounds like this is going to be the last fight of Act 8, I think. And Sin has something new for me to talk to me about as well. I gotta say, real quick, I'm a little, like, I really don't think there's going to be much more to Act 8 after I go here, so I'm pretty sure after this I'm going to be headed into Act 9, but I gotta say I'm a little surprised that we haven't seen from Grigor. I know that some of the NPCs talked about, you know, what he decided to do, and I was hoping we would get to catch up to him at some point, but maybe later, I don't know. Alright, Sin.
In Azara's grotesque little garden, you'll find an old friend of mine, the yawning maw that is Yugo, but a soft portrait of what that pathetic creature has come to believe about the nature of fear. Those who look upon him see their own fears reflected in his horrifying visage.
Wait, hold on. So this... Oh, okay, so that's... Sin, why you didn't give me this quest before? Why did you wait till now? I mean, I'm pretty sure I would have gotten that one done probably faster than the bathhouse one, because I ran through the area so fast. Like, did I miss it? I don't feel like I missed that quest. What was the trigger for getting that going into the area? I don't know. That was weird. That seems like they should have given this to me earlier. Whatever. All right, Yugol.
Vile scholars seem compelled to answer all manner of strange and troubling questions. Yugol was one such scholar. Whilst plumbing the depths of humanity, he came to believe that there was no truer expression of humanity than pure terror. He would induce terror in children, and then capture the reactions with an eldritch mirror, devices of his own creation that could petrify fear for extended study. Through his gallery of reflected terror, Yugol came to understand human nature so well that he was able to manipulate his way into the vile halls of leadership, and eventually grew so feared and renowned that he ascended into godhood.
That's horrible. Oh my gosh, this guy is crazy. All right, I can't wait to fight that guy. Okie dokie, guys. I'm going to go ahead and be done with Path of Exile today. No, I'm not. Hargan's got something else to say.
I heard tell of an ancient Vaal scholar who bore the name Yugal.
What the?
He'd conduct these grisly experiments in pursuit of some piece of nasty wisdom tucked in the nether regions of human terror. Practiced on young kiddies, no less. Scaring the living shite out of Vaal toddlers and then nabbing their fare within a hall of thaumaturgical mirrors. Could be the whole story's a crock, and here's where it gets even hazier. Seems old Yugal found something in that fare, enough to scare a whole swag of Vaal into worshipping him. Honestly, some people will worship anything for a bit of spiritual peace of mind.
I might have to agree with you there, Hargan. Now, same thing with you. What did you... He just said he heard a tell of this Yugal, dude. It's like, did you hear it from Sin when I was talking to him over here? Because you sure as hell didn't bother giving this to me at a reasonable time. You waited until now. I could just strangle you. Anyone else have any problems that need to be solved today? Do you have anything else? No? No, how about you, Nivali? Do you have a quest? No, no one's got any quests. No one's got needs anything. I've got a big axe. I know how to swing it. Don't get... Okay, I'll stop being ridiculous, guys. All right, I'm going to go ahead and for realsies be done with Path of Exile today. Made my way a little bit further through Act 8. Got my first map. Found out I cannot use said map until I finish Act 10. Fair enough. So next time I'm going to be traveling to the High Gardens to deal with Yugal, and then I'm going to be heading to the Harbor Bridge, and I guess I'm going to grow a couple of goddesses, and I assume that'll be all of Act 8, and maybe I'll get to start Act 9. Alrighty guys, thanks again for watching, and bye for now.